Craig here from North 49. And are you a healthcare practitioner who is looking for a functional outcome measure with your patients with balance problems? Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. In this video, we'll review our go-to functional outcome measure for this patient population, being the activity-specific balance confidence scale, how to use it, and how to interpret it. So with that in mind, let's see how it's done. With the activity-specific balance confidence scale, it really tests one's perception to do 16 day-to-day tasks requiring balance. Each task is graded from 0, which equals no confidence, to 100, which equates to complete confidence. And each task has a varying degree of difficulty. So if we pull it out, you can see there's 16 questions. And on the top, there's a scale of 0 to 100. And then how confident are you that you not lose your balance or become unsteady when you, so question one is walk around the house. Let's go to question 5, stand on tiptoes and reach for something above your head. Let's go to question 10, walk across a parking lot to the mall. Let's say 15, step onto or off an escalator while holding onto parcels, such as you cannot hold onto the railing. So all these tasks have varying degree of difficulty and the person fills it out. And the specific instructions that you tell them beforehand is for each of the following, please indicate your level of confidence in doing the activity without losing your balance or becoming unsteady from choosing one of the percentage points from the scale from 0 to 100%. If you do not currently do the activity in question, try and imagine how confident you would be if you had to do the activity. Also, if you normally use a walking aid to do the activity or hold on to something, rate your confidence as if you're using these supports. If you have any questions about answering any of these items, please speak to the administrator. So they fill it out and we score it accordingly. So we average it. So we take the total score, divide it by 16, and that gives us our score. If they score less than 80%, that correlates to them having the perception that their unsteadiness is impacting their ability to do their normal daily activity. If they score less than 67%, it's been shown that these people are increased risk for a fall. And people 50% or less are typically bedbound. And I find this interesting. As times you will have people walk into the clinic and they score like 48, right? And that means they're typically bedbound. So here it shows their perceptions for some reason definitely off. And with the activity-specific balance confidence scale, there's a moderate correlation with the dizziness handicap inventory in individuals with a variety of vestibular disorders. So that is the activity-specific balance confidence scale, a great functional outcome measure to measure someone's perception of disability, seeing what specific day-to-day tasks they're having challenges with throughout the day, and also to track, we can use this tool to track that over time. So if you like this video, feel free to like and subscribe, but also too, check out our website at courses.north49therapy.com where we have a whole bunch of other learning opportunities for you. Hope to see you there.